Hi, want to learn the trigger in one video? Yeah, this video is perfectly for you. Just enjoy. Believe me, in one video, I'm going to cover each and everything of the trigger except one important concept. But believe me, you will enjoy. Just go with that. So today what we are going to start with, we are going to start with the trigger. The most important concept, the database we are having. Right now, we are familiar with the procedure, we are familiar with the functions, we are familiar with the package. And today, what we are going to start with, we are going to start with the most important topic in the database, or a trigger that we are going to start with. So first of all, I'm just going to connect with Oracle. So I'm just going to write connect.tiger. I'm just going to put like set server output on. So today we are going to start with the most important topic in the database. It's a trigger that we are going to start with. First of all, we need to understand, like, see, before the trigger, we are already familiar with the stored procedure, we are familiar with the functions, we are familiar with the packages. Before the package, function, and stored procedure, it was the collection like PLSQL table, nested table, vArray, cursor, ref cursor, strong ref cursor, weak ref cursor. So we are familiar with all these topics in the PLSQL. Now I'm going to start with the next topic, it's a trigger. So first of all, what exactly the trigger is? See, it's a kind of PLSQL block. It's a kind of PLSQL block. It's a kind of PLSQL block that will execute automatically. That's the good thing about the trigger. That will execute automatically. After or before the DML operation. After or before the DML operation. So what exactly the trigger is? It's a kind of PLSQL block that will get executed automatically after or before the DML operation. So this is what exactly the trigger is. See, someone can ask you the question like PLSQL procedure, PLSQL functions, PLSQL package, these are also, again, it's a PLSQL block and trigger we are having. What is the difference in that? So this is the interview question, like, what is the difference between a stored procedure, functions and package and the trigger? Remember, the procedure function that we are talking about, it's a part of database. After the compilation, it will be the part of the database, number one. Number two, the most important thing, always you has to execute. It's not going to execute automatically. And when we are talking about the trigger, it's basically part of table. It's not the part of the database. Once you create the trigger, that trigger will get associated with the table. And it's auto-execute. We don't need to execute that. Remember, because trigger is the part of the table, that's why when we drop the table, we'll also drop the trigger. So this is the important thing that always we need to remember, like, what is the difference between a stored procedure and function? Yeah, everything is written over there. Like, the stored procedure and function, it's a part of database, has to execute. The trigger is a part of table, and the trigger will execute automatically. So this is what the difference between the procedure, functions and the trigger. Now the next thing is why the trigger is required. Why trigger? And the answer is, if we want to put certain restrictions or validations over the table. If you want to put certain restrictions or validations over the table or tables column, we use trigger. Why we use the trigger? If you want to put certain restrictions or the validations over the table or tables column, then we have to use the trigger. Okay, let me start with the example. So what I'm looking for, like I want to create a trigger that will restrict the insert statement, insert command with table. See, what I want to do, I want to apply a trigger that will restrict the insert command with the table. Like we are having the table and someone is going to insert the value, he or she will get the error. Like, see, this is the lockdown time and you cannot insert the value into the table. So how we can create the trigger now? So I'm going to create a trigger. This is the syntax that we need to remember. I'm just going to write create or replace trigger. Create or replace trigger. And the name of the trigger is trig1. And here I'm writing before insert on EMP. So I'm just writing create or replace trigger trig1, and here I'm using before insert on EMP. So before is what? It's a trigger timing. So this trigger will get executed before. It's a timing of the trigger. Before what? So it's the operation. This is the triggering operation, and this is the table we are having. So what I'm saying, like create or replace trigger trig1 before insert on EMP. Now I'm going to write begin, and I'm just going to raise the error. I'm just writing raise underscore application underscore error. So I'm just going to write raise underscore application underscore error, and I'm going to give the entire message like 20987. This is the error number. You are already familiar with error number should be from -20,000 to -21,000, and I'm just giving the message like insert is not allowed, it's a lockdown time, that's why insert is not allowed. Oh, that's good. That's the beauty of the trigger. I'm going to run this @e:trig1.sql. I am just going to make it compile and do one thing. Try to insert the value on EMP table. Insert into EMP, and I'm just going to put like imply number, comma imply name, comma cell values. I'm going to give imply number 1. Imply name is this one, and I'm going to put the cell name. See what message? Oh, it's a different message. It's a syntax error. I'm just going to give the name of the field like ename. See what message we are getting. We are getting the message insert is not allowed, it's a lockdown time. This is the beauty of the trigger. Trigger is basically used to put certain restrictions. These kind of restrictions we can apply, like if you are going to put the insert and you are going to get this error. So this is how we can apply the trigger. Now I'm just going to, it's not only the insert, I am also looking for, so I'm just going to make it comment. Okay, now so it's not that insert, like I'm also looking for if someone is going to apply even insert, update, delete anything. you should get the error. So I'm just going to write restrict the insert update and delete command with table. So how we can do that? And also I'm looking for the appropriate message. So I'm just writing create a replace trigger trig one before insert or update or delete on EMP. And here I'm writing if inserting. Inserting is the keyword. I'm writing if inserting, then you are going to give the message like raise insert not allowed, it's a lockdown time. Again I'm using else if updating. Then again I'm going to write like raise underscore application underscore error, and I'm just going to put like update is not allowed. The same way I'm going to put the value for delete also, and I'm writing else if deleting. You are going to get the message like delete is not allowed. And finally I'm going to put the endif over there. Yeah, so this is the trigger. If I'm going to run this, yeah, trigger get created for me. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to delete the value delete from EMP. See the message, delete is not allowed, it's a lockdown time. I'm going to put the update EMP set cell is equal to 9000. See the message, update is not allowed. So this is how we can put the trigger, and this is really the good thing. Like if I want to perform any work or any task automatically, in that case what we need to use, we need to use the trigger, and this is how we can do that. So this is how we can apply the trigger. Now the next thing is like types of trigger. We are having the two types of trigger is there. One is statement level trigger. One is a statement level trigger and one is a row level trigger. So we are having the two types of trigger. Remember, a statement level trigger execute once for a statement. These are the example of a statement level trigger. It's going to execute only once for your entire statement. Like see, I'm just going to put delete statement. Delete from EMP where imply, I'm just going to put delete from EMP. How many record get deleted? It's the entire table I am talking about, because I am writing delete from EMP. But you are getting the output only once, because it's a statement level trigger that we are applying, and a statement level trigger will execute only once for the row, for the entire statement. So this is the statement level trigger, it's execute once. Okay, I will give you the example. And now what I'm looking for, see, at first I'm going to make it comment. So now you are familiar with how we can apply the trigger. Now what I'm going to do, suppose what I'm looking for, if I'm going to put insert or update of ename, so what I'm looking for, I want to create a trigger. That particular trigger will convert the value of ename into the uppercase. So if suppose I'm going to insert or the value of ename, or I'm going to make the updation of ename, and I'm going to put the value in the small case, so that will be get converted automatically into the uppercase. So how we can do that? So I'm just going to write like insert create or replace trigger. I'm just going to use create or replace trigger trig1, and here I'm writing before insert or update of ename on emp, of ename on emp, and here I'm using for each row. Suppose I'm going to apply the update, and that particular update is going to make the impact on the 15 rows or the 10 rows. So how many times the trigger should get executed? It's the 10 times or 15 times. So that's why I'm using the for each row. It's a row level trigger. It's a row level trigger we are talking about. Now I'm going to use, and here we are writing, because what we need to do, we just need to convert the name into the uppercase. So I'm just going to write colon new dot ename. It's a trigger attribute, and I am writing colon new. New means the new value we are talking about. Colon new dot ename is equal to upper of colon new dot ename. Upper of colon new dot ename. So whatever the value I am going to give, that will get converted into the uppercase. And because it's a before insert trigger, so before the insert or update, your value get converted into the uppercase for every row. It's a row level trigger. Remember, in the row level trigger, normally we use colon new for the new value, and normally we use colon old. Old means the old value. At the time of insert and update, normally we use colon new. At the time of delete, normally we use the colon old. So here we are writing this trigger, and try to execute this and check it out, like how it's going to work for you. So I'm just going to give like, and now I'm going to insert the value, insert into emp, insert into emp, and I'm going to put like imply number, imply name, values. Imply name is number is 1, and I'm going to give the imply name like it's in a small case. Oh, value is too large. Unique constant violated. Imply number might be problem. Yeah. Oh, I'm going to give another value. One. Yeah, it's get inserted. I'm going to insert the another value. Again, get inserted. I'm going to update the value. Update emp. Check it out. Like select star from emp. See, I have inserted the value in the lowercase, but now it's get converted into the uppercase. It's get converted into the uppercase. Why? Because we are using trigger over there. So whatever the value I'm going to give, it will get converted into the uppercase. Now I'm just going to open the file once again, and here we are writing the trigger, like create a replace trigger trig1 before insert or update of ename on emp for each row. It's a row level trigger. Now you can ask me the question, like again it's not very much clear, like what is the difference between statement level trigger and the row level trigger. See, here we are not using for each row, so these are the statement level trigger. I am going to show you the difference, like a row level trigger. Suppose I am just going to display the message over here, like dbms underscore output dot put underscore line row level trigger. I'm just going to give some message. Just check it out, like how many times the trigger is going to execute. Set server output on, and I'm going to run this. Yeah, and I'm going to apply the update command over there. Update emp set ename is equal to, like I'm writing update emp set ename is equal to xyz, and here I am writing where department number is equal to 20. Naturally in department number 20 lot of records are there. See, we are getting the message 5 row updated, and how many time your trigger get executed? It's 5 time, because there were the 5 row. We are getting the proper message over there, row label trigger. So this is the row label trigger. It's going to execute once for a row, because we are using for each row. So it's a row label trigger, and we are getting the message 5 times, means your trigger get executed 5 times over there. So this is what exactly the row label trigger is, and this is how we can apply the trigger. This is the good thing. Like if you are going to put the values in the small case, it's going to convert automatically in the upper case. So this is how we can put the trigger. Okay, I'm just going to work with another example. Suppose what I'm looking for, I want to create a trigger. I want to create a trigger, and okay, suppose we are having some table, like department table we are having, and might be someone is going to remove the record from the department table. So someone is trying to delete the value from the department table. Delete the value from the department table. What I'm looking for, like, okay, if you are going to delete the record from the department table, it's fine. But see, I'm just going to put the trigger over there, and that particular trigger will do the magic for you. What the magic is? They will just copy the data in another table. So what I'm looking for, like, you are going to delete the record from the department table. That deleted record will get copy in another table. So how we can do that? So basically I'm taking the backup of the data. I'm taking up the backup of that particular table's data. So I'm just going to use create or replace trigger. Trig one, I'm just going to make the change. Trig two, and I'm writing before delete on department. Before delete on department. And here I'm using for each row. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write insert into depth copy. It's a new table. It's a new table because we need to copy the data in another table. So it's another table. I need to create that. I am writing insert into depth copy values, and I'm going to use colon old dot department number, because we are deleting. At the time of delete, what we need to apply? We need to apply colon old. At the time of insert and update, what we need to use? We need to use colon new. So I'm writing insert into depth copy values colon old dot department number comma colon old dot department name comma colon old dot location. That's it. And we need to create the table also. So I'm just going to create the table. Create table depth copy. Create table depth copy as select star from department. I don't want to copy the data. So I'm just going to give the false condition where department number is equal to minus one. Yeah, this table is already there. I'm going to make the truncate table depth copy. Yeah, let's get truncated now. So I'm going to create the trigger now. Yeah, trigger get created for me, and this is the table we are having, like department. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to delete the department number 40. But before the delete, I need to check, like, is there any data in the EMP table with the department number 40? Okay, I'm just going to make the change over there. Update EMP, set department number is equal to 30, where department number is equal to 40. So I'm just going to make the change. Yeah, one row updated, and I'm going to apply the comment. Yeah, perfectly fine. So now we are having the data, like, and I'm going to delete this department number 40. Delete from debt. Delete from debt, where department number is equal to 40. Oh, one row deleted. Oh, the data get deleted, but we don't need to worry. It's already get copy with the another table. Debt copy. Oh, that's the good thing. Like you deleted the data from one table, and that deleted record is going to store in another table. So what we are doing, just we are doing the magic with the trigger. Even we don't have the data loss. Like you are going to delete the record, you are really happy, like, oh, I deleted the record. But the thing is that the actual data is going to store in the table also, in another table. So this is the magic of the trigger that we can apply. Even you are going to delete the value, yeah, perfectly fine, just delete the record, nothing wrong with that. But at the same time, the deleted record is going to copy in another table. So this is how we can do that. Naturally, to run this, I need to create the table first. So what we need to do, we need to create the table first. Create table debt copy as select star from department, where department number is equal to -1. I'm just going to put the false condition, so it will not copy the data, it will only copy the structure. And after this, we need to compile this program, and this program run for you. And then whenever you delete the record from the department table, that deleted record will get copy into the debt copy over there. So this is how we can put the trigger, and this is the really good thing about the trigger. By the use of trigger, we can do a lot of things. Like, okay, what I'm looking for, I want to create a trigger. Suppose I want to keep track the information, like I want to keep the track. Keep track of insert, update, delete. So what I'm looking for, I want to keep the track of how many insert operation or the update operation or the delete operation performed on EMP table. I want to keep the track of this. Like, see, EMP is the master table. And what I'm looking for, like, in master table, a lot of transaction is going on. Like, every day, a lot of things is going on. Like, insertion, updation, deletion. I want to check it out. Like, how many operation is going on? What operation is going on? And I'm also looking for the date and time. Like, in what date and what time that particular operation is going to perform. It's happened with that particular table. So, what we need to do, I'm going to create the table first. I'm creating the table called create table TBL track. In the TBL track, I'm just going to put like operation, like what operation get performed over there. So operation is of type varchar 20, and at the same time also I want to put the date and time also. So I'm just going to write like op date is of type date, and separately I want to put the time over there. So I'm just going to write like op time operation time, and as such time is nothing, it's already included with the date, but I'm going to put varchar 2 over there. Nothing wrong with this. Create table TBL track operation op date and varchar 2 of 20. Yeah, so table get created for me. So this is the table we are having. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write ed e colon slash trig 1 dot SQL, and I'm going to keep the track of the insert, update, delete operation over there. And yeah, just for the information, like what are the column name and all, I'm just going to make the copy of this. Okay, it's also required for you. Yeah, Now I'm going to create the trigger. I'm just writing create or replace trigger trig1 before insert or update or delete on emp table, on emp for each row. Now I'm writing over here, like if inserting then what I need to do, if someone is going to insert the value on the emp table, what I need to do, I'm just going to write insert into tbl track values. What value I need to put? At first I need to give the operation, like operation was insert comma operation date. So I'm just going to give the system date over there, sys date, and I also need to give the time over there. So what I'm going to I'm just going to put 2 underscore char of sys date comma hh colon mi colon ss our minute second. Yeah, so if you are going to apply the insert, you are going to insert this value over there. I am writing if updating then I am going to write insert into tbl track operation will be update. The same thing I am going to put like else if I am just going to apply deleting over there, deleting. Then what we are looking for, I'm just going to write insert into tbl track values, it's a delete. And if I'm going to run this, and we are getting the message like this particular trigger 2 is associated with the another table, and our trigger is not going to replace that, so we need to make the different name over there. So I'm just going to change the name. Yeah, it's trigger 1, it's fine. Yeah, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to apply the insert operation, insert into emp imply number comma imply name. I'm going to put the values over there like imply number 1 and imply name is this one. Okay, I'm going to perform the update operation over there, update emp set ename is equal to like this, where imply number is equal to 1 2 3 4, and I'm going to delete this also, delete from emp, and I'm going to put like where department number is equal to or imply number is equal to, and I'm going to give like 1 2 3 4. So we just perform the 3 operation over there. Now check that table, select star from tbl track. See, you just perform the insert operation, this was the date and the timing was this. You apply the update operation on the table and you perform the update operation like this, on this particular date, on this particular time. So this is really the good thing, we are tracking the all the operations on the emp table. So suppose we are having some tables and all, we can simply apply the, like we can generate the log kind of information, like every detail is there with me, like even we can also mention like the name of the user and all, everything we can mention over there. So this is how we can do this. So these things we can do by the use of triggers. So this is the really beauty of the trigger. So now we are having the statement label trigger, we are having the rollable trigger already you are familiar with. In the rollable trigger we need to apply the for each row. With the rollable trigger we can apply colon new, colon old. So these are the few examples of the trigger. Now suppose what I'm looking for also, once again I'm going to give the another example of the trigger. Like so my question is, suppose we are having a table. In my table I don't have any primary key, I don't have any unique, nothing is there. We are having a table, in my table nothing is there as a primary key and unique. Now what I want to do, I want to apply like only unique records would allow, it's not the duplicate values. But the problem is we don't have the primary key, we don't have the unique, but still we want to apply the restrictions over there, like duplicate entry is not allowed. So how we can do that? Again, the answer is the trigger. By the use of trigger we can do that. Okay, let's start with this. So my question is, we just need to restrict duplicate entry in table. So how we can do this? I'm just going to write create or replace trigger trigger 1. I'm going to give the another name like trig 3. Before insert on, I'm just going to give the name like I'm going to give the table name like test 1. So create a replace trigger trig 3 before insert on test 1, and here I'm writing like for each row we just need to restrict the duplicate entry, and here I'm writing if colon new dot imply number is equal to. Okay, at first I'm going to create the table, so you will get the clear picture like what exactly is there with the table. So I'm just going to create a table called test1, create table, the test1, in the test1 we are having the imply number is of type number of 4, and we are having the imply name is of type varchar 2. Nothing wrong with that. Oh, test 1 is already there. I'm going to create another table with test 9. Okay, so this is the table. So at first you need to create the table over there, and see here I'm not going to use anything, like right now in my table nothing is there. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create the trigger on this. So this is the table we are having, test 9. So I'm just going to write it's a test 9, and we are having the imply number and imply name. Duplicate means what? Like either the imply number or imply name we can check, like it should not be the same. So I'm just going to write select count star into variable name. Suppose I'm going to use the C from test 9, where imply number is equal to colon new dot imply number. So whatever the value I'm going to put, so it's going to use select count star into C from test 9, where imply number is equal to, I'm just going to give like colon new dot imply number, and this C is basically what, it's a variable, so I need to declare, and this is the location where we can declare the variable H, and here we can declare the variable. Now I'm going to write C is of type number of 4 colon equal to 0. Now I'm writing if C greater than 0. Initially it will be 0. I am writing if C greater than 0, then what I need to do? I just need to display the message rage underscore application underscore error, and I'm going to give the message like insert not duplicate not allowed, duplicate employee number not allowed. And if run this, yeah, invalid trigger specification, that we need to check. I'm writing creator press trigger before insert on test 9 for each row. Okay, it's not the is, we need to use the declare over there. That was my mistake. Yeah, I'm just using at the rate /trigger one dot SQL. Yeah, trigger get created for me. Now if I'm going to insert the value, insert into test 9 value employee number 1 and employee name is this one. Yeah, this record get inserted. Once again I'm going to insert the same value, we are getting the message duplicate employee number not allowed. So this is how we can put the trigger. Even in the table we don't have the primary key, we don't have the unique, and by the use of trigger I'm going to put the restrictions over there. Yeah, again you are going to get the message. This is how we can use the trigger. So trigger is really, it's an interesting kind of thing, like a lot of things that we can do by the use of trigger. Okay, now the next thing is I'm going to discuss, like someone can ask you the question like how many types of trigger are there, and if you are going to give the answer like there is the two types of trigger, it's a statement level trigger and row level trigger, might be like someone is not going to be satisfied with your answer. This is the genuine answer like you are giving, like there is the two types of trigger, one is a statement level and one is row level. But might be in the interview and all, someone going to ask you the question types of trigger, and you are going to give the answer like we are having the two types of trigger, might be some the person is not going to be satisfied by your answer. So what exactly the proper answer of this? This is the proper answer, but see, normally people don't think in this way. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to mention few things over there. Types of trigger. So how many types of triggers are there? Already you are familiar with, one is statement level and one is row level. Okay, now we need to understand like row level, statement level. So what we can do, we can write before insert statement level trigger, statement level trigger, and at the same time we can write before insert row level trigger. So it's two. Again, like we can apply after insert a statement level trigger and after insert row level trigger. So how many? It's four. Now the same thing we can apply like before update a statement level trigger and before update row level trigger, after update a statement level trigger, after update row level trigger. So this is again, it's four and four. Again the next is like before delete a statement level trigger, delete a statement level trigger, and before delete row level trigger. Again before delete statement level trigger, sorry, after delete a statement level trigger, and again after delete a row level trigger. So how many types of trigger is there now? It's total 12 types of trigger, and one special trigger is also there. One special trigger is also there, that is called instead of trigger. So remember, if someone is going to ask you the question like types of trigger, and the person is not going to satisfy you with your answer like a statement level and row level, in that case it will be better just you can say like, oh, total 13 trigger is there, 13 types of trigger, 13 trigger is there. How is 13? Yeah, 4 4 4 12, and this one is instead of trigger, it's a special kind of trigger is there that we can apply. So total 13 types of trigger is there. That's really interesting. Yeah, a statement level, row level. So we are having before insert a statement label, before after insert a statement label, the same thing, it's a row label, it's a row label. Yes, please. My next question is, what are the sequence of execution? I will tell you. Now the next thing is sequence of execution of the trigger. I want to put the sequence of execution of the trigger. Okay, might be it's an interview question, like I'm going to create the few triggers over there. So I'm just going to write I'm just going to create a trigger called create or replace trigger trig 5. Before insert on, in the previous example my table was test 9. So I'm just going to write before insert on test 9, and it's a statement level trigger, and I'm going to display the message dbms_output.put_line. What I'm writing over here, I'm just writing before insert a statement label trigger. So it's a before insert a statement label trigger is this. Okay, it will get execute because slash is there. Now I'm going to create the another trigger by the another name on the same table, create a replace trigger and trig 6 before insert on test 9, and here I'm using a row label trigger for each row, and I'm going to give the message before insert a row label trigger. It's perfectly fine. Now again I'm going to use create or replace trigger trig 7 before, in the place of before I'm going to use after insert, and I'm just going to display the message like after insert statement label trigger, and again I'm going to use like 9 trig 9 before, again I'm going to use after. So we are having the different types of trigger over there. So my question is, on the table we are having the 4 trigger is there. It's a before insert statement label, before insert row label, after insert statement label, and after insert row label. What will be the execution sequence? What will be the sequence of execution? What trigger will execute first? What trigger will execute last? So this might be your interview question. Okay, yeah, trigger get created, and I'm going to insert the value, insert into test 9 values. I'm going to give like, see what message we are getting. This is the execution sequence, like at first before insert a statement label trigger will get executed. So a statement label trigger will execute first before insert, then before insert a row label trigger will get executed, then after insert row level trigger will get executed, and finally after insert statement level trigger will get executed. So this is the answer that we need to remember. It's an interview question. Like we are having a table, we are going to apply these four triggers on the table, what will be the execution sequence? So this is the answer that we need to remember.
So it'll start with before we insert a statement, and then before we enter into the row, and then after saying, that's the order, right?
Yeah.
That's the order we need to be aware of when we try to like insert, when we either delete or insert, right?
What I'm saying, if I'm going to apply the insert statement, the four trigger will get executed over there, and these four trigger, this is the sequence it's going to follow. This insert has nothing to do with the delete. Let's say insert basically. I'm inserting the value, so initially before insert a statement level trigger will get executed. After that, before insert row level trigger will get executed. Then after insert row level trigger will get executed. And then finally after insert a statement level trigger will get executed.
I know, but I'm saying like the same rule applies when we're doing a delete or update command,
exactly,
right?
Exactly.
Like before, like how this is following, this insert is following a certain order, sequence of order, and like it's the same applies to the update.
Yes. No.
Obviously, it's based on the pattern that it happens, not the pattern or the order that you have it listed. Because this is the order that it actually happened. It has nothing.
Exactly.
You could enter these in any order, but it would still come out with these.
Nothing to do with this. Like it can be in any sequence. I'm going to write this trigger before this trigger. Nothing wrong with that. Everyone is different. See, it's a trigger 5, it's a trigger 6, it's a 7, it's 9. Every trigger is different.
Okay, I get it. They're unique, but it's just whatever trigger exists, it'll go in basically that order.
Yeah. No. The next is, like we are having the instead of trigger. We are having the concept of instead of trigger. So what exactly is that? See, basically instead of trigger is normally used with views. What I'm saying, like suppose we are having the complex views. Naturally, like in complex views, we cannot put the DML operation over there. I'm going to create the complex view first. You people are familiar with the view also. So I'm just going to create the complex view. Create or replace view XYZ as select e.imply number, comma e.ename, comma e.cell, comma d.department number, comma d.ename, comma d.log from emp e, comma department d, where e.departmentNumber is equal to d.departmentNumber. So it's a join that we are applying over there. Yeah, view get created. If I'm going to write select a star from XYZ, yeah, nothing wrong with that. This is the view we are having. And this view is based on the multiple table. If I'm going to insert the value over here, insert into XYZ, values I'm going to give like imply number like this, and imply name like this, and I'm going to give the salary over there, I'm going to give the department number over there, and I'm going to give the department name, and I'm going to give the location over there. It's not going to allow me to insert the value. And we are getting the clear message like cannot modify more than one base table through a join view. Here we cannot apply the insert operation. That's the problem. It's not the problem, basically it's the restriction that's applied over there on the complex view. Now what I'm going to do, we are going to use the instead of trigger. Instead of trigger is basically used with the views, and by the use of instead of trigger we can perform the insert operation also. We can apply the insert operation. So first of all, I'm going to create a view over there. So this is the view we are having. It's a complex view. Now I'm going to create a trigger. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write create create or replace trigger, the name of the trigger like trig 10, and I'm writing instead of insert on XYZ. So I'm writing instead of insert on XYZ for each row. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put insert into department values. I'm just writing insert into department values, and I'm just going to give like colon new dot department number comma colon. See, we are having the department number, so whatever the department number you are going to put, it will go with the department table. So I'm writing colon new dot department number comma colon new dot department name comma colon new dot lock. So these value like department or department name and location will get inserted into the department table. And again I'm going to write insert into emp employee number, employee name and cell department number. I'm going to give like colon new dot employee number comma colon new dot employee name comma colon new dot salary comma colon new dot department number. So what I'm trying to say, like when you will apply the insert statement on this XYZ, instead of insert on the XYZ, the view value will move into the department table, like the required value will move into the department table, and other required value will move into the EMP table. So you are going to insert the value with the XYZ, but internally that XYZ data is going to move into the table EMP and department. This is the instead of trigger. If I'm going to compile this, see, oh, that's the good thing, like we are getting the error. So errors, and oh yes, yes. Yeah, create it. Now I'm going to insert the value. See, insert into XYZ values, employee number, employee name and salary, and I'm going to give the department number 50 over there or 80 over there. Oh, that's the beauty of the trigger. The data gets inserted with the, and check it out, select star from department, these data get inserted into the department table, and these record get inserted with the EMP table. Check it out. Yeah, so this is what exactly the instead of trigger is. So by the use of instead of trigger, we can apply insert operation on the complex view also. So instead of trigger used with the views, if I need to insert the values with the complex, like if I want to put the values in the complex view. So see, view is basically based on the table. So indirectly the data has to maybe move into the table. So this is how we can apply. I'm creating a view, create a replace view, view name as, this is the view, it's a complex view. And I'm going to insert the value like before, instead of insert on XYZ, it will go for the insert in department table and it will go for the insert on EMP table. So this is what exactly the instead of trigger is. Now, the few important concept is also there. I'm just going to complete that also. Like in Oracle, we are having the concept of okay. My question is, can we apply commit within the trigger? This is my question. Can we apply the commit within the trigger? Before this, like if you are going to give me the answer yes, normally it's wrong, we can't do that. But I'm going to give you the answer, what exactly this. Before this, can we apply commit within the trigger? Before the answer of this question, the few things we need to understand. Like in Oracle, we are having the concept of autonomous transaction. What exactly is that? In Oracle, we are having the concept of autonomous transaction. So right now I'm just going to explain you what exactly the autonomous transaction is. Then once again I will apply these things with the trigger, but right now I'm just going to create another file, that will be better. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write ede colon slash t1.sql. Oh, it's already there. I'm going to change the name. I'm just going to give the name like trig2.sql. I'm just going to write the normal program like declare begin. See, I'm just going to apply the insert statement, normal insert, insert into EMP, imply number, comma, imply name. And I'm going to give the values over there, like values is like this, and I'm just going to give the imply name like test. And nothing wrong with that. And I'm just going to put the commit over there. Again, perfectly fine. But one problem is there. What is the problem? Suppose this is my department table. Select department. Select start from department. This is my department table. And this is my department table. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to apply some update operation over there. Update department set dname is equal to EDP, and where department number is equal to like 40. It's like 80, nothing wrong with that, perfectly fine. Okay, so basically I am in the middle of the transaction. right now I am in the middle of the transaction. Already the transaction is going on. My transaction is already going on. But in the meantime, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to run my program. At the rate e colon stack slash trig2.sql. PLSQL procedure successfully completed. And if I'm going to apply select star from EMP, this record get inserted over there. In that particular program, you also applied the commit statement over there. Now the result is the commit of that particular program is going to apply the commit for this statement also. That's the problem. My commit was in that particular program only. In that particular program, you are going to apply the insert, update, delete. You are going to apply the commit. Perfectly fine. I don't need to do anything. But here I am writing my update statement. In this particular update statement, this update statement is different. This statement has nothing to do with that particular program. But the problem is that particular program is going to apply the commit. Your this transaction also get committed now. If I'm going to apply the role, oh, by mistake, I make it EDP. I don't need to do this. I want to change this again. So what I can do, I can apply the rollback. But right now, if I'm going to apply the rollback, nothing will happen. Oh, it's not get rollback. That's the problem. Once again, I'm giving you the example proper. The better option will be like, I'm going to show you. See, this is my program. This is normal delete operation I'm going to apply. Delete from department I'm going to working on. Delete from department, this was my statement, nothing wrong with that. And here we are having the program. In my program, we are writing a lot of things over there, like insert and all. In this program also, I'm going to apply the commit. See, the problem is, like, this is the SQL statement we are having, and this is the program we are having. If I'm going to apply delete from department, nothing wrong with that. All record get deleted from there. But in the meantime, I just executed this program over there. Yeah, this program will successfully get executed. But one problem is there. The problem is this commit statement. When you are going to apply the commit statement, in fact, this commit statement is going to perform the commit for this insert also and this delete also. That's the problem. This one is the separate program. This one is the separate statement. I am going to apply the commit over here, and this commit is going to make the impact on this insert as well as on this delete. That's the problem. That's I'm not looking for. Everything should be independent. Like suppose I'm going to withdraw the amount from the my account, it should not reflected in your account also. This is the same thing. I'm going to apply the commit over there. This commit has to do with this one insert only, but it's not like that. It's going to impact this delete also. That's the problem. And how we can solve this? The answer is autonomous transaction. Autonomous means independent transaction. Independent transaction means what? If I'm going to mention the autonomous over there, then in that case, this commit has nothing to do with any other concurrent transaction or running transaction. Has nothing to do with this. So how we can do this? I'm just going to write like this for the example. And here I'm just going to write pragma. Here I'm just going to mention pragma. Pragma. Auto. Nomos underscore transaction. I'm just going to mention over there, like, we are going to start with the autonomous transaction. So I'm just mentioning pragma, autonomous transaction. Pragma is what? It's a preprocessor directives. It's a preprocessor directives. So I'm just going to mention, like, before the compilation of this program, you are going to give the instruction to the compiler, like, listen, this is the independent transaction. This commit has nothing to do with any other. That's why we are mentioning over there autonomous underscore transaction. Pragma autonomous underscore transaction. So you are going to initiate the independent transaction over there, and this particular transaction has nothing to do with any other ongoing transaction. Now if I'm going to run this, take two dot SQL. Oh, make the change the value over there. I'm just going to apply like this. Yeah, perfectly fine. Oh, before this, do one thing. I'm going to apply like delete from department. All the record get deleted. I am in the middle of the, oh, it's not going to allow me to delete. Okay, I'm writing delete from department. All the record get deleted. Nothing is there in the department now. I am in the middle of the transaction. In the meantime, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to execute that program. Like at the rate e colon slash. Oh, it's a deadlock. That's the good thing. I will tell you what exactly the deadlock is. Right now, just do one thing. This is how we can apply the get back from the deadlock. Okay. So I'm just going to write at the rate e colon slash demo bld dot SQL. Okay. So this is the table we are having. Select a star from EMP. These are the table we are having. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to delete the last record. Delete from EMP, where imply number is equal to 40. Yeah, it's get deleted. Oh, it's a imply num, it's a department number that we need to check. Department number is equal to 40. One row deleted. And I'm going to execute my program now. In that program, you are also using the commit. Yeah. Select a star from EMP. See, this record get inserted. Oh. But right now, we don't have the 40 over there, because you apply the delete operation. Now, I'm going to apply the rollback. I'm going to apply the rollback. Check it out. Yeah, it's get rollback. That's the beauty of the autonomous transaction. And to apply the autonomous transaction, what we need to do? To apply the autonomous transaction, see, this is autonomous transaction. This is how we can do this. Autonomous transaction means this particular commit has nothing to do with any other running transaction. It's only going to perform for this. So this is what exactly the autonomous transaction is. Autonomous transaction means we are talking the independent transaction. Now, my question was, again, I'm going to come with the trigger. And my question was, can we apply the commit within the trigger? Okay, try to do this. That will be the best option. And I'm going to write the trigger. Yeah, I'm just going to write the trigger over there. I'm writing create a replace trigger, trig one, before insert or update of ename on emp for each row, and I'm writing like colon new dot ename is equal to upper of colon new dot ename. And what I'm going to do, like what I'm looking for, like if you're going to apply the insert or update, suppose I'm writing create or replace trigger trig one before insert on department. So what I'm looking for, if you are going to insert the value on the department, insert into depth copy. I also want to copy the data, depth copy values, and I'm just going to give like colon new dot department number comma colon new dot department name comma colon new dot location, and I'm going to apply the commit. Nothing wrong with that. So what I'm going to do in the trigger, I'm going to perform the insert operation over there. I'm going to insert the value into the department copy. And okay, after the inserting, I'm just applying the commit. So just run this. Yeah, trigger get created for me. Why the true trigger get created? Might be some comment is missing over there. Oh, this trigger, I need to make it comment. So this is the trigger we are having. Yeah, trigger get created for me. Now I'm going to apply the insert statement, insert into department values, department number, department name, and the location I'm going to give. See what message we are getting, and we are getting the message cannot commit in a trigger. Your program will get compiled, but when you insert, apply the insert, update and delete, you will get the error like this: cannot commit in a trigger. And if we want to do this, what is the solution for that? Can we apply commit within a trigger? No, we can't do that. If we want to do, then what is the solution for that? For yes, we just need to use autonomous transaction. Autonomous transaction. So I'm just going to write create or replace trigger for each row, declare pragma autonomous underscore transaction. Pragma autonomous underscore transaction. Now do this at the rate, yeah, insert the value, perfectly fine, nothing wrong with that. Again I'm going to insert the value, yeah, perfectly fine, nothing wrong with that. Trigger is also working for me. So this is the interview question. Can we apply the trigger commit within the trigger? The normal answer is no, we can't do that. But if you want to do that, how we can apply? By the use of autonomous transaction, we can do this. Now, so this is what exactly the autonomous transaction is. This is how we can apply the autonomous transaction.
So yeah, autonomous transaction allows us to like commit within the trigger, right?
Yeah. Now, after this, one important thing is there. Like, we are having a special kind of trigger. See, right now we are just familiar with, like, trigger is applicable with insert, update, and delete. Right now we are just familiar with, like, trigger we can apply with insert, update, and delete. Insert, update, and delete. What I'm saying, like, we can apply the trigger with the insert, update, and delete. Now my question is, can we apply the trigger with drop or the truncate or any DDL statement? This is my question. See, what was the definition of the trigger? The definition was, it's a kind of PLSQL block that will execute automatically after or before the DML operation. Here I am not mentioning, like, it's a DDL statement. So trigger is only applicable for the DML statement. Now my question is, can we apply the trigger with drop, truncate, or any other DML DDL statement?
Is it no?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yes, we can do that. Okay. For this, we are having a special type of trigger. We are having special types of trigger. And that particular trigger, for this we are having special types of trigger, and that particular trigger is known as database event trigger. Remember, database event trigger is the part of the database. It's a special types of trigger. It's a not normal trigger. Remember, this is the part of database. It's not the part of the table. It's a special kind of trigger. So how we can apply this? Okay, I'm just going to write create or replace. So I'm just going to write create or replace trigger. Like, I'm just going to apply restrict underscore drop. Oh, I'm going to restrict the drop. You cannot drop. So I'm writing before drop on database. Before drop on database. And here I'm just going to mention, like, I'm just going to give the message, like, res underscore application underscore error. Res underscore application underscore error. I'm going to give the error message, like, 20987. Like, drop is not allowed. Drop is not allowed. Oh, that's great. Run this trigger. Remember, to run this trigger, we need to connect with the sys, like the admin. So I'm just going to apply connect slash as sysdba. Then I'm going to run the trigger. Yeah, trigger get created for me. Now, connect with Scott Tiger. Connect Scott slash Tiger. Try to drop the table. Drop table EMP. Oh. See the message, drop is not allowed. Now you can't drop anything. Test one. Drop is not allowed. You cannot apply the drop statement in your Oracle. So now what to do if I want to drop the trigger? Okay, what we can do? We cannot drop the trigger, perfectly fine. What we can do? Exactly, that's one. That's only the solution that we can apply. So in the place of drop, I'm just going to write before rename on the database. I'm going to give the message, because rename is the less used command. I'm just going to write rename is not allowed. That will be better. to CMP, rename is not allowed, but you can drop that. So this is how we can apply this trigger. This is how we can apply this trigger. So this is really the special kind of thing. Like, can we apply that? See, we are applying the trigger on the rename or the drop. We can also apply the trigger with like alter, create. You cannot make any alteration over there. You cannot do any create over there. So we can apply the trigger on create, alter, drop, rename, truncate on every command. So this is really the good thing that we can apply. So this is all about the trigger. Yeah, one important concept is left over there. But initially you people just need to do the practice with, that is called mutating error, mutating trigger. We are having the concept called mutating error or mutating table, mutating error or mutating table or mutating trigger. What exactly is that? So this is the important concept. This is only the concept that left behind with this trigger. But before this mutating, it will be better just try to complete this. Like, lot of things are there. Initially just complete this, and after that in the next session I will go with the mutating trigger, mutating error and all. I'm just giving you the introduction what exactly the mutation is, mutating is. See, mutating means what? Like, you are in the middle of the transaction. You are in the middle of the transaction. Suppose I am performing insert, update, delete. I am performing insert on the EMP table. Insert EMP. So that particular table is what? It's a mutating. Mutating means what? It's in the middle of the transaction.
Updating.
Yeah. It's in the state of change. In the state of change. That's basically the mutating is. I will discuss this. It's a really the good concept. And it's an interview question also. That's why I will cover this